Dan Swong, Chief Economist at Mesirow Financial. Peter Schiff, President of Euro Pacific Capital. Welcome to you both. Peter, great to see you in studio. Diane, just want to say, do you take offense to the Dr. Doom moniker? You remember the last guy that had it was a huge economist.
Oh, I know.
A household name. So I think
Henry Kaufman.
So you embrace it.
Sure, no problem. At all. Sure, there has been productivity growth in China, no doubt about it. In fact, one of the reasons...
And in the U.S., some remarkable growth in the U.S.
Well, I would disagree there. I think that's more sleight of hands for the statisticians. I mean, if we really had...
Excuse me, I'm from Detroit. Have you been in an auto plant recently? We have
That's
a more efficient
true.
Economy. We have, yes.
Even we don't have even a more efficient economy.
Yes, we
have
do
a bubble
have a
economy. We're borrowing from abroad to consume. That's not efficiency.
There's no tax increase coming in the next couple of years. Monetary policy is spectacular. We have freer trade than ever before. And not only that, but there are no incomes policies things here. I think Peter's just totally off base, and I don't think it's going to be... I mean, I just don't know where he's getting his stuff. The
well, one of us is, off base, but it's definitely not me. I mean, it's not wealth that's increased in the last few years. We haven't increased our productive capacity. All that's increased is the paper values of our stocks and real estate. But that's not real wealth, no more than the NASDAQ was wealth. When you see the stock market come down and the real estate bubble burst, all that phony wealth is going to evaporate. And all that's going to be left is all the debt that we accumulated to foreigners.
Peter, I'm going to take a bet with you on this one. I'll bet you a penny on this one that if you'll sign a letter saying that if you're wrong, you'll sign a letter that you were wrong to me in this. But you're just way off base. There is nothing out there that tells us we're going to have a nice slowdown, but it's not going to be a
crash. All right, let me ask you this.
I'll bet you a lot
more
than a penny.
Point to the housing market, and they say that a huge percentage of the jobs created, some argue as much as 30% of the job creation over the last few years, has been because of the housing boom, whether it's construction, whether it's mortgage brokers, real estate brokers, et cetera. And if that all goes away, what happens
there
to
will
those
be
jobs?
Lots of, there will be lots of things to fill it back up again, Michelle.
Bottom line is, I'm a big bear on the U.S. stock market. You know, the Dow Jones already is down 20% year to date, priced in gold.
Right.
That is a tremendous loss of purchasing power. The Dow has lost better than 60% of its value since its
like
peak
good,
in 2000.
Sounds like good management to me. Sounds like good management of the economy to me. It's just like a corporation. You know, if we have a huge deficit, I mean, we're making money on the money we're borrowing more than the people who are getting for lending it to us.
No, we're not.
Like corporate America.
I mean, we've sort of seen that play out, and I think that, you know, it's interesting that you go through a 20-year period where gold is underperforming, you get a 2-year period where gold is outperformed, and every gold bug comes out of the woodwork and wants to tell you how you should own gold and not Google, and I'm not sure I can rationalize that decision.
Remember, gold was in a bear market for 20 years. Stocks were in a bull market for 20 years. That's changed, and people have to understand that or they're going to lose a lot of money. You know, I mean, the gold rally, I think, is still early on. I don't know, do you own any gold yet, Art?
No, just my wedding ring.
All right, well, you see, let me know when you got some.
What do you think gold is saying?
Well, you know, first of all, you just described the U.S. market as being bulletproof, and I think gold is telling us that it's about to get shot full of holes here. The housing market is just beginning to unravel. We're seeing the tip of the iceberg here in the mortgage sector, but probably...
How do you put together all this gloom and doom? What data tells you this, Peter?
Well, aren't you looking at the news reports coming out of the mortgage market?
I'm in the middle of it, yeah.
Yeah, aren't you looking at the glut of houses on the market for sale with no buyers and the collapse in the subprime market?
Well, I wouldn't call it a collapse in the subprime market. There's been some difficulty in the subprime market.
Well, it's just starting.
I'm also looking at housing prices, which have had an orderly decline. I'll tell you something that makes a lot of sense to me. You talk about the collapse of the NASDAQ and that incredible bear market that we had. Those are usually once-in-a-lifetime events.
Well,
and you're
so
suggesting that in very short order, less than 10 years later, we're going to have another one?
Well, in a different asset class, sure, in real estate.
I think I might maybe take a little issue with the other guest here. I mean, in that, I mean, the whole concept of this U.S. economy is teetering on recession. You know, with all due respect, I think is absurd. It's completely absurd.
Well,
because
the stock market,
excuse me, sir, let me finish. I think that stock market, generally speaking, does not give false positives or false negatives on recession.
Where were you in 1999? In 2000, the stock market doesn't give false signals.
Well,
of course it does.
Now,
you're starting to see it in the housing market. You had a lot of people over the past 4 or 5 years borrow a lot of money that they can't afford to repay. They were able to keep it together for a while on these artificial teaser rates. But as these rates are starting to reset, you're starting to see what's happening in the housing market. It's going to throw through to the entire economy, and consumer credit's going to dry up, and we're going to be in a recession, and it's going to be a devastating recession. It's not just going to be a few quarters of negative growth. It's going to last for years.
Stephen, jump in here. What do you say? He's saying it's a disaster.
Well, you know, I really don't see this economy that he's talking about.
Why hasn't it happened? Why hasn't the collapse happened? Why hasn't the skeleton, the subprime skeleton, come fully out of the closet and scared the living daylights
well,
out
remember,
of everybody?
It takes a while. It takes a while for this stuff to filter through. Look at how long these hedge funds were able to pretend that these subprime debt securities that they hold actually have value or close to par when they're really practically worthless, if not completely.
And now that they're not pretending anymore, nothing's happened.
No, the world hasn't ended.
So one of these days we're just going to have to stop predicting that this same old thing is going to cause the end of the world.
It's production that's important.
Let's not talk about
savings.
America being a burden on the world. America is the shining beacon
of
the world.
No, we're not.
Production is in many cases the low end of the totem pole. The high intellectual content created here. There is only one Microsoft.
Why do we have a $60 billion a month trade deficit if we're producing so much stuff?
And that
because we're so rich, we can afford it.
No, that's not.
Because our money is so valuable, because our credit is accepted worldwide, that billions of peasants worldwide are willing to work in poorly lit, poorly ventilated factories just to get our paper money, because it's that precious.
No, it's our paper money is precious. We print it. It cost us nothing.
Look,
the world is
going
to wake up to this con. Well, how are the consumers served by having the value of their money, the value of their wages and their savings diminished?
I don't think that that has any impact. The Fed doesn't have any impact on that at all.
Of course it does.
Those who aren't familiar with you, this has been your prediction for how many decades now?
Well, not decades, but it's certainly been my prediction for the last 7 or 8 years, and I've been dead on right.
You have?
Sure. Look what's happened since 2000.
So I think as more and more people are starting to see that Wall Street is conning them, you know, and hey, if these guys can be so wrong about Enron, so wrong about WorldCom, so wrong about Cisco or any of these companies that were so heavily touted, why can't they be wrong about the whole thing, about what they're saying about the economy, about what they're saying about the market? And they are wrong. All they're trying to do is sell stocks. But I can tell you now, as we speak, the U.S. dollar has hit a new low for the year, and I think this last bull market in the dollar, which went from 1995 to the present, is over. So the market is still extremely overvalued, and don't believe the propaganda. And that's what it is. When you're listening to an analyst on a lot of these popular financial shows, or the mainstream Wall Street firms, you're not getting investment advice. You're getting propaganda.